Hello, my fellow Padawan! Guess we have a little update here!
You see, I uploaded recently a short clip about how the playfield creator of my framework does its job, even creating a playfield background combination from custom images.
Now I have to present you my Sprite Editor, which will make sprite creation for the 3600 much easier.
The editor is able to animate your sprite so you can see how it will work on the real thing. Also, you can change the NUS size settings to stretch them if you wish. The framework is capable of handling 15 frames for each sprite if the product of the height and the number of the frames won't exceed 256 bytes. Also, the editor helps by coloring the tiles are set on the previous frame, so you don't have to page back.
But the funniest part is, you can test your sprite in the emulator using one of the scenes you created previously for the project.
Let's see, we have this ghost, and I made this castle just for this test, and if you double click a name in one of the list boxes, it will find and select the pair, so you won't have to bother with that. As testing sprites, you can have the same options as on the playfield tester if you turn the TV mode switch to black and white, but by default you can control the movement of the sprite and shoot in front of you. You can use the reset and select button the same way as in the playfield editor, changing the color of playfield and background elements, but you can use the left difficulty button to make the sprite move behind the playfield, or use the right one for making it looping through NUSIZ values.
Also, I added a small feature using some free bits of some already occupied bytes, letting you turning off some of the screen elements.
Because of my screen border feature, normally you won't be able to remove any elements from the screen, but this will override the vertical position they get in WeBlank, so they will be wiped off.
Also, I discovered a strange fact that the vertical position calculation of sprites goes from the top of the screen, while the ball and missile position goes the other way. Don't worry, that's just pain for me, Fortari will handle it for you. Also, before I go with the audio editor, which will be a really hard task, I'm gonna create two other kernels, which are really similar to this one, so you can say I'm gonna add some elements at the cost of removing some. One will be a multi-sprite kernel, a little bit similar to the one you can find in Atari Basic, and player 0 will be the one that will be multiplied because of the architecture, how I designed my code. And the other one will let you use an Atari ST mouse, because I just love the idea using mouse on the Atari 2600, and it will be a really fun experiment, so stay tuned.